Why do you say جزاك الله خيرا? Sure, some of you might say to show gratitude and thanks, but why do you need to do that? The main reason is that Allah loves gratitude. Abu Hurairah reported that the Prophet said, He has not thanked Allah who has not thanked the people. To show gratitude to Allah, we must show gratitude to the people in our lives. It keeps us aware of reality. We realize we have blessings that others might not have. It helps us approach the world with an open mind. That is why I would like to thank the administration, Brother Haroon and Brother Abdul Qadir, for all that they do to benefit the school and us students. There are many reasons to appreciate the administration. For one, they encourage events such as Arabic Day and Quran Day. These events celebrate student achievements and appreciate many exemplary students for their hard work. They also provide a refreshing change of scenery from the everyday routine of school. The admin has also instilled a sense of brotherly love in the school. The faculty, teachers, and staff love each other for the sake of Allah. You always see them smiling, showing their appreciation for each other. I hope this attitude passes on to you all. I'm sure it will. This unity and brotherhood is important in Islam. Among the seven categories of people shaded on the day of no shade are two brothers who love each other for the sake of Allah. How else has the administration benefited us? How about the morning adhkar on Fatihah, the reminders to pray sunnah, the overall Islamic integration into the educational experience, just to name a few. The administration constantly reminds us about our Islam, this invaluable gift that we should hold dear, that we should hold close to our hearts. Many of us pass off these reminders, but listen for once and think critically about it. Let us ponder, where else will I be constantly reminded of the actions, teachings, principles of Islam? Surely not in college or in any other educational institution. They might even bombard you with anti-Islamic messages in both subtle and obvious ways. This is an especially dangerous situation because of the hadith in which Anas ibn Malik reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The people will see a time of patience in which someone adhering to his religion will be as if you're grasping a hot pole." That is to say that, especially today, so many things are pulling you away from Islam. Without a strong foundation, a Muslim will crumble under the barrage. However, the administration strives to help us build that sturdy foundation. We thank the administration for their dedication and sacrifice to this mission. They have been here long, long before us. If you don't take them as role models, then take their lessons and try to implement them in your own lives. Think about it. What are you all going to do after graduation, after you leave the school? Achieve success, am I right? As Muslims, we measure success not only in this world, but also in the hereafter. Follow the teachings of Islam. That is the only way to be successful. And the true success is to step your foot into Jannah, wherein you will abide forever. The administration strives to instill those teachings in us all. For that, we should all say, Jazakumullahu khair. Jazakumullahu khair for listening.